is a heathen practice. Pagan, heathen, go together. But yet there are Christians who are practicing what the heathens practice. The church allows the heathen practices to come into the church. Now listen, I'm not, don't get mad at me because I'm supposedly extreme. I'm just, honestly, I'm just simply on the Bible, that's all. But I'm supposedly extreme. And you know, God bless other churches that, you know, they do the harvest so that our children don't feel left out on this holiday. We have our own substitute. We have our own substitute activities so that our children don't feel left out. Guess what that is? That's compromise. That's compromise. Instead of teaching our children, listen, this is a national hail day. This is a national hail day. We don't partake of it. We're not going to compromise and substitute and have a merry-go-round and have pumpkins so that our children don't feel left out. What we're doing is teaching our children how to compromise, and when they get old enough, they're going to full-blown go into Halloween. Versus being taught the right way from the beginning, we don't partake of that. We have nothing to do with that. So when they understand, when they become an adult, it's not like they know, oh, we're not a part of that. They know, oh, our whole life we never was a part of that. Oh, we know, oh, that's National Hell Day. That's what happens. That's just either one. And when the Bible says, train up your children in the way that they should go, that's in the kingdom ways, then they shall never go away. If they do go away, they will come back. Speaking of that, I want to give honor to my brother, my older brother. It's his birthday today. And honestly, truthfully, if it wasn't for my brother, I wouldn't be alive right now. I said if it wasn't for my brother, I wouldn't be alive.